And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain, my friend.
Yo, what's really good, guys? You're through to LSAT TVKO. Thank you for watching another video. It's greatly appreciated. Do not forget to hit that subscribe button, like, comment, and tell your friends. Right, so let's talk about Alexander Povetkin versus David Price. The penultimate fight before the AJ fight with Joseph Parker. It was a very good scrap. Anyone who watched the preview video for David Price versus Povetkin would have seen that. Basically, we broke it down to exactly how this fight went. You know what I mean? And that's not patting myself on the back. That's just pointing out that it was quite easy to predict. It was a fun fight whilst it lasted. It was actually a really good watch. This was always one of the fights that I had my eye on, because I kind of knew that it would go down the way it did. Povetkin was on the front foot. He was willing, came forward at will, and because he was up against such a bigger opponent, he wasn't scared to vary his shots at all. He saw the benefit of going to the body a lot, but then he wasn't scared to go up top either. Didn't seem to ever be threatened by Price or his power. That changed though. I think it was the end of the second round where David Price seemed to catch Povetkin not only off balance but caught him flush, sending him backpedaling beautifully with a left hook. How Povetkin stays on his feet, I do not know, but in the end, I guess he took the punch pretty well. The fourth round was entertaining, both guys going for it, but for me, David Price always seemed vulnerable just simply because we know how chinny he is. His fights of yesteryear, we've seen him get wobbled by lesser men than Povetkin, so although he was holding his own, he's actually defending pretty well throughout the fight. There was always that big question mark of what would happen once Povetkin actually landed with a clean shot. And that clean shot came in the fifth round by the means of a right hand, which basically stunned Price to the point where Povetkin just basically had an open goal. If we want to use football terms, and he just had that free shot with the left just to confirm the damage and sending Price sprawling back on his backside. And it was a brutal knockout, to be fair. Every time you watched it on the replay, it just made you wince even more. It's like, ooh, it was one of them ones. Like I said, if you watched the preview video for this fight, you'd have seen that we went for a fifth round KO. And yeah, that's exactly what it was. Like I said, we ain't got no crystal ball. It's just sometimes you get a bit lucky and that's how it goes. But yeah, where David Price goes from here, it's very hard to see any real comeback from him, unfortunately. I touched on it in a previous video. He's suffered many, many defeats and many of a brutal nature, just like last night. And you wonder how much that leaves in the tank when fighters get defeated like that. How much do they really want to come back and get in the ring? I'm sure David Price will have a long think about it. I'm not sure if he came out and said anything about retirement last night. I didn't catch the post-fight interview. But I guess that may be something that he will be thinking about right now. As for Alexander Povetkin, he displays all the attributes that we know he's got. He's got a great variety of punches. He hits very, very hard. Even if he gets caught flush, as you saw last night, it's hard to detract him. If he's on a mission, he's a hunter, a great fighter. Great ability, and very intelligent in the ring. Brilliant ring IQ as well, does Povetkin. I said to a few friends of mine that I wouldn't mind actually seeing Povetkin versus Luis Ortiz. I think that would be a fight for the purists, but I'm not sure what that fight does for either man, unless they make it like a final eliminator for one of the belts, and then the winner then fights AJ or something like that. That could potentially happen. I wouldn't mind seeing Povetkin versus Dillian White. I believe Dillian White came out and called him out. So yeah, there's loads of fights to be made for Povetkin. He's not a spring chicken, that can be said. I think he's 38 now, so time is, you know, is not on his side. But certainly he looked fresh enough, sharp enough, and strong enough to still be able to compete at the very highest level in this division. So yeah, well done to Alexander Povetkin. I know a lot of people may not be happy with the result, given, you know, recent scandals involving Povetkin. But you know, as a boxing fan, I just want to see fighters in the ring. And yeah, he's an interesting element of the heavyweight division, that has to be said. But anyway, guys, I'm going to leave it there. What do you guys think of the fight? What did you think of Povetkin's performance? And where do you think Povetkin can go at the age of 38 in the heavyweight current landscape, let me know. But for now, guys, I'm Elts. It's a TVKO. And I'm out of here, man.